Hello and welcome to today's video where we will discuss the pros and cons of natural birth versus cesarean delivery. This is a very important topic for expectant parents who want to make an informed decision about their birth options. But before we begin, please subscribe to our channel and hit the bell icon to get notified of our latest videos. And hit the like button to get notified of our latest videos. Natural birth, also known as vaginal birth, is the traditional way of delivering a baby through the birth canal. And cesarean delivery, also known as C-section, is a surgical procedure where the baby is delivered through an incision in the mother's abdomen and uterus. Both methods have their advantages and disadvantages depending on various factors such as the health of the mother and the baby, the size and position of the baby, the availability and quality of medical care, and personal preferences of the parents. So, first of all, let's start with the pros of natural birth. Some of the benefits of having a vaginal delivery are shorter recovery time. The mother can usually walk and resume normal activities within a few hours or days after giving birth, as compared to needing at least a week or more to heal from a C-section. Next is lower risk of complications. The mother has less chance of developing infections, blood loss, and anesthesia-related problems such as nausea, vomiting, and headaches. The baby also has less risk of respiratory distress, allergies, and injuries during delivery. Next is higher rate of successful breastfeeding. The mother can initiate breastfeeding sooner and more easily after a vaginal birth, which can help establish a strong bond with the baby and provide optimal nutrition and immunity. Next is more natural and empowering experience. The mother can actively participate in the labor process, feel the contractions and the urge to push, and experience the joy of seeing and holding the baby for the first time. Now, let's look at the cons of natural birth. Some of the drawbacks of having a vaginal delivery are more painful than a C-section. The mother may experience intense pain and discomfort during labor and delivery, which can be alleviated by using pain relief methods such as epidural, breathing techniques, massage, and hypnosis. However, some pain relief methods may have side effects or interfere with the progress of labor. Next is more unpredictable than a C-section. The mother may not know when the labor will start, how long it will last, and how it will progress. There may be unexpected complications that require medical interventions such as induction, forceps, vacuum, or emergency C-section. Next is more potential damage to the pelvic floor. The mother may suffer from tears, cuts in the vaginal area, which can cause bleeding, infection, and pain. The mother may also develop pelvic floor disorders such as urinary or pelvic organ prolapse or sexual dysfunction. Now, let's talk about the pros of C-section. First is less painful than a natural birth. The mother can avoid the pain and discomfort of labor and delivery, as she will be given anesthesia to numb the lower part of the body. The mother can also choose the date and time of the delivery, which can be helpful for planning and preparing. Next is less risky for certain conditions. The mother and the baby may have a lower risk of complications if they have certain medical conditions such as placenta previa, placental abruption, umbilical cord prolapse, fetal distress, breech presentation, or multiple pregnancy. Next is less impact on the pelvic floor. The mother can avoid the damage to the vaginal area and the pelvic floor muscles that may occur during a vaginal delivery, which can prevent or reduce the occurrence of pelvic floor disorders. And now, let's examine the cons of C-section. Some of the drawbacks of having a cesarean delivery are: first is longer recovery time. The mother will need more time and care to heal from the surgery, which can affect her mobility and ability to care for the baby. The mother may also experience more pain, swelling, and bruising in the incision site, which can be managed by using painkillers and antibiotics. The mother has a higher chance of developing infections, blood loss, and anesthesia-related problems such as nausea, vomiting, and headaches. The mother also has a higher risk of having complications in future pregnancies, such as placenta, placenta previa, uterine rupture or repeat C-section. The baby may also have a higher risk of respiratory distress, allergies and injuries during delivery. Next is low rate of successful breastfeeding. The mother may face more challenges and delays in initiating and establishing breastfeeding, which can affect the bond with the baby and the quality and quantity of breast milk. So, as you can see, there is no clear-cut answer to which method of delivery is better or worse. The best choice depends on the individual situation and preferences of each parent, as well as the advice and guidance of their doctor. The most important thing is to be well-informed, well-prepared, and well-supported throughout the pregnancy and the delivery process. So, that's it for today. We hope you found this video helpful and informative. And if you did, please give it a thumbs up and share it with your friends and family. If you have any questions or comments, please leave them below. And don't forget to subscribe to our channel and hit the bell icon to get notified of our latest videos. Thank you for watching, and we will see you in the next video. Bye-bye.